Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome back to our channel once again. And it is my hope and prayer that this video is going to find you guys in good health. Personally, I am fine as you can see. Kisumu is fantastic. And maybe you could also let me know where you're watching the video from. The county or the country, in case you are out of the republic. Ladies and gentlemen, something is happening in Kenya Kwanza, and particularly in UDA Party. And unless William Ruto will move very fast, cracks will soon start emerging. Just the other day, you heard what the former Bahati member of parliament, Kimani Ngunjiri, stated. And I remember telling you here that in politics, there's normally the spiral effect. And of course, you are going to witness more of such cracks. Earlier today, Millicent Omanga made some interesting post on her official Twitter handle. Millicent Omanga is not your ordinary Kenyan. Millicent Omanga is a former nominated senator. And Millicent Omanga was among the few individuals who were appointed as the chief administrative secretary. As a matter of fact, probably, you never know, maybe she's still earning salary out of that. This is what Omanga posted, that Governor Sakaja has sent county askari to close down my businesses in Nairobi despite my businesses operating with all their requisite licenses. This illegal and unjustified action follows my comment on the Auditor General's report on Nairobi County, which appears to have infuriated him. Now, from that alone, it shows you that something is wrong somewhere. Why would Sakaja close down Millicent Omanga's businesses? Millicent Omanga and Sakaja were both UDA candidates for Nairobi. And therefore, I don't expect them to undermine or even frustrate each other. I don't expect them to do that. And the statement proceeds, I reject this bullying and political intimidation in the strongest term possible and ask Sakaja to keep off my businesses. I remain steadfast and unbowed and firm that I'll not be silenced by such cowardly act. As a matter of fact, I know Millicent Omanga operates a pub somewhere along Othaya Road. I used to frequent that place when I was in Nairobi, when I used to stay in Nairobi. People used to tell me, Apo ni kwa Omanga, good place in Lavington. I don't know the other businesses she's talking about. According to Millicent Omanga, this is what has caused all this. This is what she posted. Actually, there was that tweet by the Daily Nation that Nairobi County spent 9 million on tires without explanation. And then she quoted that post or that tweet by the Daily Nation, I cry for my beloved country. So Millicent Omanga believes this is the cause of her problems. So in this video, I want us to figure out what is really happening, especially between Omanga, the message which Omanga is trying to relay, and Johnson Sakaja, and probably the deep-rooted division in Kenya Kwanza, and particularly in UDA Party. But before you do that, for those who are watching this channel for the first time, please take a second or two, click that subscribe button, so that next time we produce a video like this, YouTube will automatically notify you. And to the subscribers, I want to continue thanking you guys for your continued support. Because without that support, this channel cannot be where it is. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, allow me to dive in. But before I dive in, allow me to also take this opportunity to thank the following people for the coffee which they sent to me earlier. It goes a long way in supporting the channel. I'm so grateful. You can also do the same using the numbers you are seeing on your screen. Today is Friday, and there's no harm sending me one for the road. Ladies and gentlemen, let me try and understand what Omanga is saying. Number one, in my view, Millicent Omanga is actually addressing none other than the President of the Republic of Kenya, William Samoei Arap Ruto. And she's doing it indirectly. Why am I saying so? Millicent Omanga has been very close with William Samoei Arap Ruto. As a matter of fact, when Millicent Omanga was nominated to the Senate, it was because of her efforts and from William Samoei Arap Ruto. And that's why William Ruto really wanted her to become the senator. She did not succeed in becoming the senator. And the truth is, Millicent Omanga was nominated to serve as the chief administrative secretary. I'm sure if even if that number was to be reduced the way court recommended from 50 to 23, Millicent Omanga is still going to be among those 23. But why would Sakaja, the governor of Nairobi, target such kind of individual? That is the question Millicent Omanga is asking William Ruto. That I, Omanga, operating a business in Nairobi with all the licenses, can be targeted. Probably, Omanga made a call to those who matter in government or even state house, but none of them picked the call. That's why she's ranting. If you go through this tweet clearly, she's mentioning something here that I reject this bullying and political intimidation in the strongest term possible. So she believes this is bullying and political intimidation. Omanga is part of UDA. Why should she feel being intimidated in Kenya Kwanza? The truth is, there is serious infighting in Kenya Kwanza. Number two, the tweets is also exposing the division in Kenya Kwanza.
Ukweli wa mambo. Minister Omanga, former senator, nominated senator, amechibu, amesema, Sakaja ametufail. Unaona ametuma maaskari kuangaisha yeye kwa biashara yake. Leave alone Omanga aoperate. Hii serikali tulitafuta sisi wote. Omanga alikuwa anatafuta hii serikali kabisa. Umetufeli wewe Chomso Sakaja. Hii Nairobi ni kwa Kisii. Bukisio wewe sipata kura bila kushinda kiti Nairobi bila mkisii. Nimeona ulitoa msichana. Alikuwa chief of soccer leta ka nephew ya Machogu. Machogu mtu wa kirani. Machogu ya unyumba Kisii atoshi. Huyu msiria kijana umeweka ni nephew ya Machogu. Machogu huko Kisii. Wacha niseme ukweli record straight kwa ulimwengu isikize. Nimeona choose of late. Machogu akiappoint watu kwa Nyariba alimasaba. Kiransi. Eh? Msichana ya Kangwana. Ndio ni vizuri. Lakini Kisii iko na nyumba mingi. Arafu, relative yake. Eh, unajua hao masies kama Ugwaru, Machogu, wanasema uko na position ya board of directors. Eh, niko nayo. Nikuwekee mtu mmoja na mimi tuma yako nikuwekee.
Let me just take you back a bit. When William Samoei Arap Ruto, the president of the Republic of Kenya, decided to appoint one Cleophas Malala as the UDA Secretary General, Millicent Omanga did not really congratulate Malala. But what I remember, after some time, Millicent Omanga took to her Twitter and addressed Cleophas Malala and accused him of failure to perform his responsibility as the UDA Secretary General. The truth of the matter is that there were two camps emerged when William Ruto appointed Malala as the Secretary General of UDA Party. There was one camp which believed they were the original owners of UDA Party, and therefore if William Ruto wanted to appoint SG, he would have picked one of their own. And that's where Rigathi Gachagua is, that camp. And then there is the camp which believes in William Ruto's decisions. And this is where Sakaja is. As far as the position of the Secretary General of UDA Party is concerned, there were two camps, even up to now. Sakaja is the only individual alongside the Malala who are present when Ruto was negotiating with Mudavadi. Mudavadi said that. I think William Ruto also stated that when they made the move. So Sakaja and Malala are very close. And the fact that at that particular time, Millicent Omanga had to say whatever she said, it simply means this division in Kenya Kwanza. Number three is misuse of power. I think power has gotten into the heads of some of these Kenya Kwanza leaders. If you look at the way Kipchumba Murkomen is operating, now Malala, others misusing power. So basically, Omanga is just lamenting about the misuse of power. And lastly, the hustler narrative is also dead. How many people do you think those Omanga's businesses, in quotes, have employed? Several people. So the truth is, the truth of the matter is that there is serious division in Kenya Kwanza, and it's going to affect the party moving forward. I don't know what you think. That's my take. Until next time, this is Lee Makwiny. Bye-bye.